Hello everyone, welcome to Amar Jyoti's Crush Your World. Today I am here once again with my new tutorial. Today I am going to make another poncho, a virus poncho. So I am going to make with acrylic yarn. I am taking a white color acrylic yarn, 4-ply white color acrylic yarn. So we are going to make with this poncho, and the crochet hook that I am going to use is 4mm crochet hook, tapestry needle to hide the ends, and a pair of scissors to cut the ends. So you can make in 2 colors, 3 colors, or a multi color yarn also. So I am taking this one color, white color poncho I am going to make. It is an adult poncho. Okay, so we are going to make 102 chain stitches. So after making slip knot, make 102 chain stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Like this, you have to make 102 chains for making the neckline. I'll meet you after making 102 chains. Now I have made 102 chain stitches. Keep your chain stitch straight, do not let it folded. So make a slip stitch in the first chain stitch. By keeping it straight, make a slip stitch. And chain 2. Now we are going to work one half double crochet in each of the chain stitches all around. Okay, so this is chain 2 is our first half double crochet. In the next chain stitch, make one half double crochet. In next, I am taking the ending loop also in making this half double crochet, so that you will not need to sew it or hide it at the end. Extra end you will cut afterwards. Like this, you will cut this extra end. So in each chain stitch, make one half double crochet. You can make double crochet also, you can make single crochet also, but I am making half double crochet in each of the stitches. So I will meet you at the end of this whole loop and slip stitch at this top. Now I have done the half double crochets in all the stitches all the way around and made the slip stitch over here. Now we are going to, this is the neckline, so we are going to start with the front or the middle, this front portion or the back portion, whatever you can say. We are going to start from the middle and going towards the shoulders, and then here will be the other side, the back side. If this is the front side, this is the back side, or the vice versa, and this is the other shoulder. So we will be making the center part of the poncho from here. So from here we are going to start it. Now start with chain 5. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. This chain 5 is our big loop. Now we have to skip next to 2 stitches, and in the third stitch I am going to make one single crochet. This one is the bigger loop, and now we are going to make 3 smaller loops. For smaller loops we are going to make chain 3. And again skip 2 stitches, and in the third stitch make a single crochet. 1, 2, 3. One more small loop, skip 2 stitches, in the third stitch make a single crochet. One more small loop. So in total we are having 3 small loops and 1 big loop. Okay, and in between we have skipped only 2 stitches in each of the space loops, even it though it is a big loop or it is a smaller loop. Now making big loop, 2, 3, 4, 5, skip 2 stitches and single crochet. Now making 3 small loops, 3 chain, skip 2 stitches, in the third stitch making 1 single crochet, 1, 2, 3 chains, skip 2 stitches, in the third stitch make 1 single crochet, 1, 2, 3 chains, skip 2 stitches, in the third stitch make 1 more single crochet, like this. So we have started from here and now we are working over here. Now we will continue till here. Okay, so in total we will work this portion for 4 times, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay, after that I'll tell you what to do. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, skip 2 stitches, in the third stitch making single crochet. Now making 3 small loops, 1 small loop, second small loop, third small loop. Okay, so 1, 2, 3 times it's repeated. Now big loop, small loop, first small loop, second small loop, third small loop. Okay, now we have reached over here and now we have to make the bigger loop, ending with bigger loop. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and skipping 2 stitches. That's it. Now we have reached the center of this. Now from here once again we are going to start with this point, bigger loop, then 3 smaller loop, bigger loop, 3 smaller loop, bigger, like this we will be having if we fold it like this. This is the center, so we will be having 3 bigger loop on the shoulders and here 2 bigger loop in the center, 2 bigger loop in the back side and 3 bigger loop over this side. Okay, now as I told you, after making first bigger loop, second bigger loop, third bigger loop, fourth bigger loop and fifth bigger loop, I am going to start once again bigger loops from bigger loop. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, skipping 2 and single crochet in the third. Now 3 small loops, 1, 2, 3. Again making big loop. See here in the center I have 2 bigger loops. Again when we will reach here we will end with the bigger loop, so it will also be 2 bigger loops here, 2 bigger loops here. This will be the center of our poncho. So I'll meet you at the end when we will be ending with the big loop. Now we are at the end of this row, ending with big loop, that is chain 5 and single crochet in the same stitch where we have started this, the chain 5 of the starting, like this. So this is the way we are going to make our, this is the starting. This first row is to make the loops almost in this pattern. We are going to repeat 4 rows repeatedly and to I'll show you how to make it increased in the increased manner. And these 4 loops are to be repeated. This is the first loop, the first row with loops. Every time we have to start with making the loops and then the other 3 rows. So basically 4 rows we are going to repeat each and every time. So first row that we have done is making loops. This is the center, first center, and this is the second center with 2 bigger loops and these are the sides with one big loop. Now starting row number 3, slip stitch in the big loop, the first big loop of this side, chain 3. This chain 3 is considered as our first double crochet in between this chain 5, the big loop. And in each big loop we have to make 10 double crochet. So if this is of chain 3 is our first double crochet, rest 9 double crochet we have to make in the this chain and this loop. So 9 double crochet in this loop. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. So in total we have to make 10 double crochet. This chain 3 is our first double crochet, rest if considering it as our first double crochet, counting it as 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 and 10. 10 double crochet we have made in this chain 5 loop or the bigger loop. After that I am going to make single crochet in the first small loop. Chain 3, shift to next chain 3, make a single crochet in that, again make chain 3, shift to next small loop, make a single crochet. Now in the first row, in the last row we had 3 loops, 3 small loops. Now in this row we will be having 2 small loops and in the next row we will be having 1 small loop. So it will be decreasing and it will be increasing its flare. Now after that you are reaching the big loop. In this big loop we are going to make 10 double crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 double crochet you have done. Now in the next small loop make a single crochet, chain 3, single crochet in the next small loop, chain 3, single crochet in the next small loop. Now reach the big small loop and again making 10 double crochet in that. So like that we have to cover all the loops. When you will reach this center portion of the back side, you have to make 10 double crochet in this loop, 10 double crochet in this loop. So total 20 in this back side and when making over here. And when you will reach at the end this big loop, again making 10 double crochet and slip stitch in the top of chain 3. Okay, so I'll meet you at the end of this row. Okay, now I have done all the double crochets in big loops and reduced small loops over here. And now we are going to start the next row. In the next row, start with chain 3. Now in the next you will find double crochets. Now we are going to make back post double crochet. So yarn over your hook and bring your hook from the back side, not in this chain 3, rather in the first double crochet. From the back side hold the total double crochet in your hook from the back side, yarn over and pull the loop through that, and then you have 3 loops. Yarn over, pull through and double crochet, again yarn over. In the next double crochet go from back side and then yarn over, pull through the loop and make a double crochet. So in this manner you are going to make back post double crochet. Yarn over, go from the back side. You are not going to make a regular double crochets. Regular double crochets will be made on these chains, but now we are not making over here, but we are taking from the back side like this. This is back post double crochet. We are making the double crochet from the back side of the post, so it will create an edge over the double crochets of first row. Okay, now one double crochet, back post double crochet in each of the double crochet. That is 10 back post double crochet we have made like this. Okay, after that make a single crochet in the first chain 3 loop, chain 3, and single crochet in the next chain 3 loop. Now we have reduced to 1, 3, 2, 1, and like this. Now again, from the first double crochet, make back post double crochet in each of the double crochets of last row. I am making back post double crochet in each of the double crochet of bigger loop from last row. 10 double crochets we had, and 10 back post double crochets we will be having after this row. And single crochet in the chain 3 loop, chain 3, single crochet in the next loop. Again you have reached 10 double crochet of bigger loop, and go make the back post double crochet, and like this we are going to finish this whole row. So I'll meet you at the end. Again, in the center, as you have made 20 double crochet, you will be having 20 half back post double crochets in the back side, and 10 we have made already, 10 rest 10 we will be making over here, and slip stitch on the top of this chain 3. So like this we have to finish this row, row number 1, 2, 3, and 4, row number 4. Now finished with row number 4, like this, made one double crochet in each of the double crochet with back post double crochet. So created an edge kind of this effect. Now starting with next row, the last row in this pattern, chain 3 as our first double crochet and chain 1. So basically we have to make one double crochet and chain 1, and this chain 4 will be one double crochet and chain 1. In the next double crochet, from the back post only I am going to make one double crochet, chain 1. In each of the double crochet, make double crochet, chain 1, double crochet, chain 1, double crochet, back post double crochet, and chain 1. Again make back post double crochet, chain 1, back post double crochet, chain 1. So in each of the double crochets that we have made in the last row, I am making one double crochet, back post double crochet, and chain 1. So like this, 10 back post double crochets and chain 1s, back post double crochet. Now when you have made 10 double crochets including chain 1s in this, in between the chain 1s, you will reach this loop, this single chain 3 loop. Make one single crochet in that, like this, and then again shift to next double crochet, make a back post double crochet, chain 1, back post double crochet, chain 1, back post double crochet, chain 1, back post double crochet, chain 1. Make one double crochet from the back post and chain 1. So like this, 10 double crochet and chain 1s, not after the last double crochet. After the last double crochet, we are going to make a single crochet in the chain 3 loop, and again starting through the next double crochet, chain 1. Like this we are going to finish this whole row. Okay, so I'll meet you at the end of this row. In each of the double crochet, make back post double crochet plus chain 1. So I'll meet you at the end of this row. Now this is the end of row number 5. So these 4 rows, excluding this first row of half double crochet, row number 2, 3, 4 and 5, we are going to repeat the same, but we have to make it an increasing manner. So how to increase it? So here for this side we have the half portion. We have 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 bigger loops. But in the next row, you will be having one over here, the bigger loop, and one in each of the center portion of these two parts. So one over here, bigger loop, second bigger loop, third, fourth, fifth, and sixth over here. So total in this next row, we will be having six rows over here and six rows over, six bigger loops over here and six bigger loops over there. So in total, we are having in the first row, in the first part, we had this five this side and five that side. That is total bigger loops in first portion. In second portion, we will be having six bigger loops. Now, these bigger loops will not be over this circular portion, rather in between these two circular portions, in the valley portion. So we will be having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So total 6 this side and 6 that side, that is 12 in the next portion. And in the third portion, we will be having plus 2 more, that is 14, 7 this side, 7 that side. So I'll show you how to make an increase in this these bigger loops. So after making row number 5, we are going to do the work of row number 2 once again, the making loops portion. So how to start it? Now we are at this central portion. Okay, now making the bigger loop with chain 5. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay, now the current working double crochet, skip that. The next double crochet, skip that. In after skipping these, this current and this, in between these two double crochets, make one half double crochet in the chain one space. This is your first bigger loop. Small loop with chain 3. Again skip next two double crochets, and in the chain one space after two double crochets, make one single crochet. Smaller loop, second smaller loop, skip next two double crochet, and in the chain space over there, make a single crochet. Third smaller loop, skip next two double crochet, and in the chain space, make a single crochet. Now this first portion is done. Now make the bigger loop. Now what we have to do is, we have reached the center portion over here. Now where we have to make, see, you have skipped two double crochet from this portion. From starting again, you have to skip first two double crochets, and after that chain space, make a single crochet. So like this, you will find the bigger loop over here. Again make smaller loop, skip two double crochet, in the chain space after that, make a single crochet. Smaller loop, skip two double crochet, in the chain space, make a single crochet. Smaller loop, single two, skip two double crochet, in the chain space after that, make a single crochet. Again you have reached the end, two double crochets, and here we are going to make the bigger loop. Chain 5, skipping two double crochet this side and skipping two double crochet this side, in the chain space, make a single crochet. Like this, we are going to start with the new row. This is our looping portion. Currently it's not that much visible, but when you will start making this work over here, so this portion will start visible like this over here. Three loops and 3, 2, 1, and then here this ring portion. So I'll meet you at the end and again make a single crochet in the same space where we have started. So I'll meet you at the end of this row. So now here I have made all the loops. When we have started from here, and then when we will go at this point here, making three small loops, after that making one bigger loop, and again we have to start with one bigger loop. So this middle portion will be having the loops over loops over here also. Okay, here bigger loops and bigger loops over the bigger loops over the bigger loops. But when on the sides, we will be having bigger loops in the middle portion of these rings. Okay, after that, this is the repetition of row number 2. Now we are going to repeat row number 3, 4 and 5 once again, and then this will gradually we will be increasing our poncho. You can make as longer as you want your poncho will be. So let me see for an adult how many rows I'll be making. So like this, it will get increasing in this manner. Okay, so I'll meet you after making a couple of more rows, and then I'll show you how many rows we have to make for making an adult poncho. So I'll meet you after some time. Now I have made 12 rows in total. See, from center we can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. After making 12 rows, I have made the tassels and attached on every curve in the center the one tassel, and on every curve I have attached one tassel till the back side. So this poncho is adult size poncho. If you want to make it a small sized poncho, you can reduce the number of rows according to the size. So this is the virus poncho that I have made in white color. You can make in any other color of your choice. It looks so beautiful, so gorgeous. Hope you like my video on making this beautiful and gorgeous virus poncho. And please give it a thumbs up. Please like, share and subscribe my channel. And write in the comment section how you like my videos. If you have any suggestions, your suggestions are always welcome. And press on bell icon so that you will get the notification for each and every time I'll upload any video on my channel. And thank you for watching my video. Thank you once again.